prepared. So, hello everyone, my name is Kate, and I am one of the maid of honors. When I was 11, my family moved right next door to the Parkses, and I got to meet this lovely lady. Hey, Caroline. So, being that I was from Colorado, I did not understand anything about Maryland at all. So, lucky for me, this random girl rings my doorbell one day, extremely early in the morning, but that's okay. And she taught me all about what it means to be a Marylander. She introduced me to field hockey, lacrosse, horseback riding. She helped me realize that I have been saying on and wash my whole life completely wrong. It's pronounced on and warsh. That's with an R, everybody. Get it right. let's see. She also told me and educated me that being called hunt was not like somebody putting you down. It's actually just somebody talking to you. They don't know your name, so they call you a hunt. Let's see. She introduced me to Old Bay. And when I started telling her that I was having a lot of bad hair days and had no idea why, she informed me, "Hun, it's the humidity. We don't have that in Colorado. I don't know where that came from." Let's see. In return for all these educations on Maryland, I got the privilege of dyeing Caroline's hair with Kool-Aid multiple times, which we don't know if her mom knew that happened. Oh, she didn't know it. Every time Caroline told me that you didn't know, I was like, no, she definitely knows, because we did like your whole head like bright red. All right. Great. I thought you were lying. Caroline and I spent so many nights baking Irish soda bread, cookies, and really, really nasty ice cream. Every snow day was an excuse to spend the day hanging out and drinking hot chocolate. Caroline, you're like a sister to me. I'm so happy and privileged to be at your wedding. I'm so happy. And Luke, welcome to the family. To Caroline and Luke.
Caroline for about 6 years now. We met at Pleasantville Animal Hospital and both worked kennel. Most people would find scooping poop a crappy situation, but that's how we came to be my best friend. Throughout all those mornings and evenings we worked together, Caroline would always gab my ear off about Luke. After about a week of working with her, I'm pretty sure I knew just as much about Luke as she did. I could tell with how she said his name and just see in her eyes how much she was in love with him. They have the kind of love that authors write about in romance. You know, the really cheesy stuff. That's their romance right there. That makes you want to throw up. But it's cute, right? It's cute. Their love for one another is pure and so immensely real. I know for a fact that it makes others envious. Because of the stories Caroline tells me of her having to scare women away from Luke. They're really scary. Really scary. Through Caroline's chatter about her boyfriend Luke, we also bonded through games recreated to pass the time at the animal hospital. One of our most popular games was called the fly game. There were so many flies in the kennel area, we would smack them with rags. And I don't know why we found that so fun, but it created a great friendship, I think. Caroline also made me go up in the attic to get extra towels, even when she knew that I'm petrified of the dark. And like the good best friend that she is, she recorded me going in the attic, trying to convince me that there were ghosts up there, and I'm pretty sure there were, and then promptly posted it on social media for everybody to see. That was embarrassing. But soon our time ended at the animal hospital and it was time for Caroline to go to college. I remember this one time when Caroline was missing Luke to the point where I finally couldn't take her sad face looking at me through our Skype dates. I picked her up the next day so that she could have a long weekend with Luke and somehow managed to get through driving on the highway without having a panic attack. Needless to say, if it weren't for her, we would have never found our way home because I'm just absolutely horrible with the GPS. Like, I just can't follow those things. Once we got safely home, we spent the rest of the night eating sushi and falling back into our usual routine before she left for college. I can stand here and recount all of the amazing times that me and Caroline have had, but I'd be standing up here for like a really long time, like all night. I lost my place. I knew I'd do this. The font is just so small. Like this one time, she was catching me up when my Great Dane dragged me across the road all the way back to my house trying to catch a bunny. There was a lot of blood. Or when she tricked my cat one time into falling off the table, bringing a bunch of cookie sheets crashing down with him. And just her obsession with cotton candy in general created good memories for us. She has to have her cotton candy, especially from Rita's, the Italian ice. She'll double fist that stuff. And I have pictures. She actually does double fist it. Anyway, I'd be up here forever, like I said, if I did. So to close this speech, I'd just like to say to Caroline that I love you. My life is more blessed just having you in it, and words cannot explain how immensely happy I am for you on this wondrous day. You deserve this kind of love more than anyone I know. I know that both you will cherish and care for it dearly, because like I said, this is a one-of-a-kind love. And I had a really cool ending to this that rhymed. What was it? It rhymed with wife. Congratulations to your new life as husband and wife. There you go. I love you.
I'm gonna invite you guys to pray with me before we leave. God, thanks so much for our time together today. Thanks for Luke and Caroline. Thanks for marriage and the opportunity that the world gets to see you and your church through them. I pray for them in the days, weeks, years that follow, that they would see you show up tangibly and intimately through their marriage through each other. I pray for our time together tonight that you're glorified in the conversation and the food that we're about to eat. We love you, Jesus. In your name we pray. Amen.